Thank you, Mr. Chairman. My preceding speaker, eminently distinguished, you know, Deputy Chairman of Novatek, has given an excellent presentation on the present as well as future global gas market outlook. So obviously, I also prepared something, but since you have already gone through that, so my focus will be only to look at where does India stand today and, of course, into the future. Gas is the future fuel. There is almost unanimous view. You pick up any literature, any global think tank report up to 230, 240, 250, they all say, yes, gas is going to stay along with renewables and nuclear. Oil will come down, but it will continue to have a positive growth, maybe around less than 1% in the next 15 years. Coal growth will decline, and gas will increase almost at at 2 to 3 times of oil growth. So when you look at the, you know, in fact, in our sector, you always look at the incremental demand. What is the additional demand coming? If you look at the additional demand between 2015 and 2030, you will find that gas will occupy almost close to 50%. You know, in different reports can give, somebody will give 45, somebody will give 55, but it is around 45 to 50%. Gas alone will account for additional demand, which is coming up till 2030. Within that, you know, if you look at the sector, like Shell Global, Royal Dutch Shell, they say power will occupy a significant portion, almost 45% of the incremental gas demand. Whereas BP, they say it will be industry and transport. But I mean, there is no quarrel, both will go neck and neck and neck. Only the future will tell which sector will take more gas and all. And within that, of course, Asia will have 40% of the incremental demand, because US, you know, Latin America, as the presentation showed, are also going to consume much more. So problem is, gas is there, but different countries are approaching gas market in a different way. There is almost a race. If you look at LNG sector particularly, in fact, every quarter, every year, you have to revise your figures. Before coming to this conference, I was astounded by looking at the kind of, you know, actual figures has gone up. So let me then, you know, give you some figure on our closest neighbor, as well as comparable with India, China, because obviously when you talk about the gas sector, China comes to mind. For the simple reason, you know, 10 to 15 years back, China developed its energy policy centered on coal. And then when the climate change, environmental issues came up, they shifted to gas. Look at how they're shifting, you know, from coal to gas. And today, they're almost racing to the top. They're almost racing, and they're very, I mean, everybody says that in few years' time, they will be at the top. Their, you know, their statement by the government is very clear. They say, this is the exact language they say, that China will promote gas as a less emission intensive fuel. They don't say, like us, gas-based economy, market competition. They say gas will come here to China as a less emission fuel, intensive fuel. Then because they have a lot of coal, so they can compare, they have a target for coal also. So their gas to coal ratio, how much gas they're consuming, how much coal they're consuming, has risen from 0.3 in 2008. 0.3 means gas was 1/3 of coal, to nearly 2. Gas is double of coal, you know, in 2016. In 8 years' time, they have just changed the ratio. Why they have done? They have shown because of increasing use of gas, the PM25 has drastically come down from 2013. 2000 was the peak, and then they started coming. So from 2013, the curve, this is all in the Shell Global Outlook, you can see, you know, it's coming down very significantly. How where do you stand? If you look at India, where do you stand? If you look at China and India, you know, the official projections, if you look at both projected that there will be gas share will be 15% by 2030. As our chairman said, India started at a higher level, say from 7%, 8%, 9% present, going to 15% by 2030. China had an actual share was 5%. Was only 5%, you know. So it's now going projected to go to 17%. But the think tanks, they think probably 11 and 12 looks realistic today. China can achieve 2030. But it will be very interesting to know, for you to know, then 15% is nowhere in sight. I was just going through the very latest Niti Aayog, you know, energy scenario, Niti Aayog's action plan, which they have published. There is a one-liner that by 2030, gas share in the energy will be 7 to 8%. So it's not 15, is, you know, officially 15% still holds, but the actual, the think tank, they have revised the projections that gas will remain around 7 to 8%. Why China has gone so, you know, fast on gas? Obviously, gas needs infrastructure, logistics. You know, I forgot to tell you, if you look at you know, the, how the China has developed its gas sector, in fact, I had a copy I just brought out, you know, with Energy Information Administration latest document. They say that the projected growth of natural gas consumption in China is driven by environmental policies, by relative cost competitiveness of natural gas in the industrial and transportation sector, and of course relative high economic growth. All three are relevant for India. And China, of course, has geopolitically has cross-country gas pipelines. They're getting almost gas from north, east, west, north, south of China. But they have also gone far ahead on LNG. Piped gas is today almost twice of LNG, but gradually LNG also can grow very fast and occupy a very prime place. So that, you know, if you compare, I was, you know, till last year I was quoting 50,000 kilometers of gas pipeline. Fortunately, I just thought, let me open and see, you know, what is the current pipeline, gas pipeline, high pressure gas pipeline in China. It is 64,000. It is 64,000 kilometers of natural gas pipeline in China today. Not today, 2017. 2018 could be still higher. And do you know what is their plan? Their plan that by 2020, China should have 1,04,000 kilometers of gas pipeline. It's almost like not doubling, but 40% increase. And if you see the records, they nearly achieve whatever targets they fix for themselves. Come to India, I remember when we were preparing those 12th fiber plan, now there is no more, those plans are not there. But so far the statistics is concerned, we had about 15,000 kilometers of gas pipeline in the country. And then another 13, 14, 15,000 were planned. So today, I can bring my experience in the PNGRB board, you know, we are still stuck at 15,500, goes to 1,500, 800, so it has not even touched 16,000. Fortunately, the Jagdishpur Haldia pipeline, which has just been approved with 40% capital grant, can add about 2,600, but for that, we have to wait 2020. So this is the scenario, 18,000 kilometer pipeline, nowhere the grid is inside because it's only on the north and west side, but the east and south are, as you know, is empty. The next thing we all talk about, the residential PNG. China is today the largest household gas provider. The residential PNG connections in China is over 80,000. In fact, I keep changing that figure almost quarterly, yearly basis, 80,000. And still, they have covered only around 25% of households. They have a target to increase residential PNG connections by 5 million every year. What is our status? Our IGL and MGL in Mumbai, IGL in Delhi came in the late 90s. Till today, we have about 78 city gas, units, city gas distribution units in the country, but out of which half are almost not functioning properly. So the total residential PNG household connections as a unit is 3.5 to 3.6 million only, which is less than 1% of total, I was calculating probably the less than 1% of the total households in the, in the country. What did China did, They took care of the financial feasibility of the business, as well as provide the transporters. Very simple. When they say there will be city gas company here, they will take care of all logistic, gas supply, finance the policy, gas supply, they will engage one upstream company, do everything to bring gas to their doorstep. Finish. Simple. This is a city gas company. The other company, upstream company, allotted this city gas, provide the gas. They kept, residential PNG cost is the highest among industry and transport. Transport, industry, and resident, they are the three aspects of local gas distribution. So if you look at the cost, residential is the highest for the simple reason that in US and Europe, where it is all market-driven, the price of residential PNG is the highest. It's much higher than industrial and transport because the cost is higher. So what China did, they kept the gas price for residential PNG 30% lower than industry. So that at the end of it, the gas sold for residential sector will be still lower than industry and transport, 30% lower. Then the LNG trucks came because pipeline, as Mr. Chairman was telling, pipelines can't be connected to everywhere and anywhere, small towns and far off places. So they had a huge, battalion of LNG trucks crisscrossing the country. How did it happen, LNG trucks? Government said, all right, we'll give subsidy on LNG trucks, but just do the business. Contrast this with, India. We have all targets, everything, but the financial feasibility is still very uncertain, both at the government level and at the regulator level. Nobody knows, because there is no monitoring, neither statutorily nor otherwise, of what is the finance, both project funding as well as operating cost of a city gas company or, for that matter, LNG terminals. LNG terminals is still in, almost in doldrums because under the act, the government has to notify first a rule for LNG terminals. Rule is nothing but for the simple reason that the terminals, as per the some old, policy in 2006, has to provide excess capacity for common carrier. So following that old pipeline policy of 2006, not pipeline, natural gas sector development, they brought it under the rule. So based on the rule, the board has to make regulations providing excess capacity. So it is stuck there. Feasibility and all, nobody has done any, study that whether this 20% excess capacity or 25% excess capacity can make it financially attractive for investment. So for the last 2-3 years, there is nothing available on LNG. Registration of entities anywhere, including LNG terminals, is not happening because there is a peculiar thing in our setup that, some section has to be notified by the government in the act. So if it is not notified, the board is not empowered to look into the registration aspect. So there are, there are problems of, of these kinds which need to be rationalized. Some have to be removed, both at the statutory level, then at the government policy making level, and finally in the operative level at the PNGRB. So it's time that my only apprehension that probably we are missing again, like oil sector, we are again missing the bus. By the time you go ahead, all of the LNG price, market price has touched $10 from MBTU. So, you know, so I don't know at this stage, a lot of uncertainty how the gas sector is going to step up or going to move forward in the next 10, 20 years. Thank you. Thanks so much.